Acquired immunodeficiency syndrome is an infection caused by the retrovirus, human immunodeficiency virus. This disease is characterized by severe immunosuppression, making the patient susceptible to various opportunistic infections, malignancies, and neurological disorders. There are two different species of HIV, HIV-1 and HIV-2. HIV-1 is the most common type of HIV-causing AIDS. This species has a worldwide distribution, mostly predominating in the United States, Europe, and Central Africa. HIV-2 is mostly found in cases in Western Africa and India. There are three clinical stages in the progression of this disease. The first stage is the acute phase, a phase when there is a self-limited acute illness. The next stage is the chronic phase, which is a period of latency. And the last stage is AIDS, which is the stage where the patient suffers from the full-blown disease and CD4 T-cell count is less than 200 cells per cubic millimeter. So most patients, around 50 to 70% in the acute phase of HIV infection, display non-specific symptoms of illness. This is a self-limited phase of acute illness called acute HIV syndrome or acute retroviral syndrome. Symptoms may develop within 1 to 6 weeks after infection. Patients may exhibit symptoms like fever, sore throat, fatigue, generalized lymphadenopathy, diarrhea, and myalgia. The illness resembles a flu-like syndrome. In the acute phase, HIV antibodies may not be detected. Testing for HIV infection when there are no HIV antibodies may yield a false negative result. The period of transition when the patient develops detectable antibodies towards HIV is called seroconversion. Testing a patient for HIV after seroconversion would yield a positive result. This may happen 6 to 12 weeks after initial infection. The period between the initial exposure to the virus, when there are no antibodies towards HIV, to seroconversion is called a window period. After the patient starts mounting an immune response, viremia decreases and there is a period of latency without any clinical symptoms. This period of latency can last for many years, at least 7 to 10 years before progressing to full-blown AIDS. However, there are patients who are fast progressors and the latency period lasts only for 2 to 3 years. There is also a small population of HIV patients who are long-term non-progressors. Latency period in such patients could last for more than 10 years. So during this period, there is a steady decline in the CD4 T-cell count in the lymph nodes and circulation. And when the CD4 T-cell count falls below 500 cells per cubic millimeter, certain patients show chronic fever, weight loss, and develop infections like candidiasis and herpes zoster. This period is called AIDS-related complex. And when CD4 T-cell count goes below 200 cells per cubic millimeter, the patient is said to have developed AIDS. Patients develop opportunistic infections, neoplasms, and neurological disease. Patients also have chronic long-term fever, lymphadenopathy, and diarrhea. The most accepted classification of oral manifestation of HIV is the Easy Clearinghouse classification. The manifestations are divided as per how commonly or strongly these manifestations are associated with HIV.